Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. So I'm going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti AI LPR, the license plate recognition camera. Now, it's not a small camera. Let me just show you this, give you an idea of its size. I'm not going to be a big technical review. I want to show you what you get in the box because there are quite a few bits to go together. So let's get on and do that. So to start with, you're going to get a get started guide, some useful information in there, so it might be worthwhile you opening that up. You are then going to get a drilling guide here, put this the right way around, for the wall base plate. So the base plate can go onto a hard surface. We've got an exit for the cable so it can stay on the outside straight down the wall, or obviously you're going to come through this hole here. Here are your two screw holes to screw that to the wall, and then the base of the camera screws in place like that. To help you do that up, you also get this tool, which we'll show you in a moment, and you also get this key to allow you to tighten up the knuckle joint again, which I'll show you in a moment. You are going to get your small packet, I think I showed you there, of screws and lugs for various ways to secure that. You also get a pole mount bracket. So you can see the angle there, it's going to clamp onto the pole. You then get a metal zip tie here that would obviously pass through the hole there that you can just see and allow you to clamp that to the pole. Now, on the bottom of this, as we've seen with a lot of the new Ubiquiti cameras, we already have a welded on RJ45 connection. So with this, we essentially get the other end of this that's going to clip on here and create a waterproof seal. So we have several components for that. So we first have the end cap. Through that end cap, you're going to pass your RJ45 connector or your cable. And you're going to have one of these three different bungs that's an option. Some are for if the cable hasn't already been cut and you're going to pass it through. You have some options here where the cable has already been had an Ethernet adapter on the end, an Ethernet connector. So again, you can just pass that through and then clamp that round. So obviously that is then going to essentially end up in the end of your connector. Connector here with your cable having go through with your RJ45 on this side. Your end cap's going to do that up and do that nice and tight, and then this is going to clamp on and give you your watertight seal. So I think that that is the main components that make this up. You also get in this box essentially some moisture absorbing, I'm not going to open that, but moisture absorbing sachets, because we have seen in some of their cameras where you do get moisture inside the lens, mainly for environmental changes and the heat of the camera. So this is going to, I'll show you where this gets fitted. You do have a little diagram inside here of where you're going to open up the camera to put that. So that's a great thing that we're seeing, I think will help some of the condensation issues that we've had. So then let's actually have a look at the camera itself. Now this is pretty large, as you can see. So this is a license plate recognition camera. That is what it's designed to do. We do have a microphone on here. It's a 8 megapixel 4K camera. We've got full extended IR on the front here out to a good number of meters. It's IP66 rated. It's all in one construction, different to where we've seen something like the Ubiquiti DSLR, where you had to build the components together. So we've obviously got all of this already built in. It is designed for that distance. It has a 3x optical zoom, again, to help you get the right positioning for capturing the cameras or the best option. Like we said on the back, it already has a welded in RJ45 connector, and we have our knuckle joint stem, which allows quite a few different mounting positions. I don't know whether you can just see it. We have the screws here. So once you've found the ideal position, you're going to use this tool to actually fix that all in place. Then if we look at our actual end, we've mounted that maybe on the wall or a pole. Let me just show you here. We've passed our cable through it, or we've maybe had it come along the end up along the wall. And we're going to then bring that up into place and screw that up like that. To get the best grip on it, we can actually use this tool. We can pop it over and that gives us extra grip to get that done up tight, because obviously this camera is really heavy. So being able to do this knuckle joint up really tight along with this bracket is going to help support that. Then just the last bit on the bottom here, this is where your moisture absorbing material is going to go. So you're going to lift this up and you're going to put that inside, and that's going to hopefully then remove the opportunity for any condensation to happen with inside the lens as well. So hopefully that has been useful, all of the bits that make up the AI LPR. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on network, firewall, wireless devices, camera security, how to get the best out of Unify Protect, for instance, or set some of these AI features up as well. So why don't you head on over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.